Louise here today for Lawnfawn and welcome back to the channel. Today I have an ocean themed card to share with you all. I'm using Seahorse and Around, You Are Sublime and Fantastic Friends. As you can tell, Fantastic Friends is one of my favourite sets. It's super yellow and super stained, but I just really love all of the fish images in there, as well as like the coral and the seaweed. I think it works really well with newer released stamp sets like You Are Sublime. All of the new images in that set really complement as well, and I thought it would pair really nicely with Seahorse and Around as well. I'm using circle stackables to also create a bubble background. I'm then also pairing it with a ton of colours of Lawnfawn cardstock. I do end up bringing in a couple of more shades as well, just for my scene. You could use distress inks if you wanted to, but I love just using cardstock. It's super easy and super fun, and when you're taking a lot of time to like colour images and things, it's just a lot easier and quicker to die cut some plain coloured cardstock, which is really nice to do. I'm first taking a piece of white cardstock, and this is just cut to a card size panel, and I'm going to line up the four smallest circle dies that come in the circle stackable set onto the top half of this panel. I am going to do the bottom half of the panel as well, but I wanted to do the top half first for the sentiment. So I'm using Best Fishes sentiment from Fantastic Friends, one of my favorite sentiments of all time, but I really wanted it curved around one of the circles. So what I decided to do is just place my entire panel into a stamping tool. Any stamping tool will work. And I'm just placing my panel inside and using the magnets to hold it in place. So now I'm taking Best Fishes sentiment and I'm just placing it down like it's originally shaped to do so. I'm then picking it up with the door and I'm just going to curve it myself on top of that door. So I'm holding down the middle part of the sentiment and curving the edges just around a little bit to create an arch shape. And I'm going to alter it a few more times to make sure that it is perfectly shaped around that circle just by placing the door over a few times and altering it as I need to. I then inked it out with some black ink once it was perfect and stamped it down a couple of times to get a really nice and dark impression. Now that the sentiment is all ready to go, I can go ahead and die cut out those circles and also die cut out the rest of the circles just by placing them randomly on the bottom of the panel as well. So now that those are all die cut out, I'm also using the same dies as I did before and cutting out circles out of the other colours of cardstock that I have as well. So I just sort of worked out how I wanted the layout to go and then cut out the sizes accordingly. So I'm using Blue Jay, Sage Leaf, Peacock, Mermaid, Moonstone, Cilantro, Number 2 Pencil and Sunflower cardstocks for all of the circles. And then cut them out. I sort of worked out, as I said before, how they were going to be laying out. So I did like the blues at the top, then the greens, and then the yellows at the bottom, just to sort of represent how the ocean would look, I guess, with the sand makes on the bottom and then some greenery and then the blue water. So I just went ahead and did that. And then I added foam tape onto the back of this Best Fishes circle die cut panel and added that onto a white card base. And then I'm using my glue tube adhesive to adhere down the circles into their respective places. So a lot of these did hang over the edges and things, but I just ended up taking a trimmer and cutting off them so they were flush with the straight sides of the card. Now that my card base is all ready to go, it's ready for some images. So I decided to watercolor my images today just for something a little bit different. I haven't done this in a really long time. I usually just gravitate towards my Copics nowadays, but I wanted something different today. So I am just inking up all of the images from the three stamp sets. I just pulled out a ton of ones that I thought would work really nicely and inking them up with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink. The reason I'm using this ink is because I want to clear heat emboss over the images. And I just like to do this because when I'm watercoloring, sometimes I can be a little bit messy and impatient and it will go outside the lines. And this way it just sort of ensures that the watercolors stay a little bit more contained, and it's a lot easier to manage as well. So now that those are all coated in clear embossing powder, I'm just going to go and set those with a heat tool and then begin coloring. So I'm using some Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers today. Again, I haven't used these in a really long time and I really enjoy them. I love how quick and easy they are. And they just have really beautiful colors as well. And when you're doing like an ocean themed card, I think it's really fun because I tend to just color like the like fish and things, whatever color I like. Like, I don't know if this is realistic at all, but I think it's fun because I just feel like you can get away with coloring like rainbow colored fish and things with like an underwater scene versus like a jungle scene or something like that. I feel like you have to be a lot more specific in those scenes, but with fish and ocean themes you can do rainbow and it's just a whole lot of fun and I really enjoy that. So the way I use Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers is I just place the marker where I think the darkest areas would be and then I blend it out with a water brush. I think the key to these markers is using a water brush. I know probably everyone knows that by now because they've been out for a long time, but that's how I generally get the best results. And what I really like about them as well is you can go like super fancy and add like different shades in like you do with Copic markers and things, but what I really like about them is you only have to use one color and it looks like you get a ton of like shading and that gradient and that build up even just using them like this way. So I really like that about them. They just are really nice to work with and they're super, super quick. So I'm just going to finish up coloring all of the images here. I didn't leave them all on screen because I just thought the process was quite repetitive and you sort of got the gist. You just place the marker where you want the darkest areas to be and blend it out as much as possible. Like I did with this fish here, I just added the tiniest bit of orange onto there and really blended it out a lot to make him a lot more like paler than that orange originally would have been. Super fun. Once I finished all of the coloring, I am just going to quickly dry this with a heat tool, or you can set it aside to dry, whatever works for you. Then I'm going to arrange how I want these fish and the plants and things to look. So I think I ended up using all of the images that I originally colored and cut, which is super nice because it means that I did actually color enough. And I'm just laying these out how I think they would look. Not necessarily realistic, like you would only have like coral and seaweed on the ocean floor, but I just thought that, you know, it's meant to be whimsical and fun. And I just adhered all of these guys into all of the individual bubbles. I think they look really cute. It's a really fun and full card, which you guys know is my favorite. I don't really do anything simply. I love to go overboard with all of my images. So I just, once I had arranged them out, I added some liquid adhesive and also some foam adhesive onto the backs of each of the images to adhere them down into place. I just sort of mixed and matched foam with liquid just according to like how the layout was. And yeah, so that finishes up my card for today. I really hope that you guys enjoy. It's super duper simple, but I really like how it turned out, and creating like my own bubble background with those circle dies was really fun as well. It made the scene come together super quickly, which is awesome. So thank you so much for stopping by today. All of the supplies that I use will be listed down below and over at the blog, and I'll catch you all next time. Thanks so much for stopping by today.